Daniel Andrews has been confronted by protesters in a backlash over controversial pandemic laws. The Premier was forced to make a hasty exit from an event in Bendigo, while Brett Sutton has been abused at Parliament House.
The Premier forced to make a quick escape as protesters gate-crashed his Bendigo tour. Angry over the proposed pandemic laws.
Kill my bill.
The Chief Health Officer and COVID Commander also in the firing line as they tried to leave Parliament on Monday afternoon with a police escort.
That's what the public really thinks of you, hey?
Crossbencher Andy Medic is negotiating the legislation with the government. He says the protesters have sent death threats to his home, this one containing a condom targeting him and his children.
They just do not deserve that type of abuse.
The legislation hands decision-making powers on lockdowns and quarantine from the Chief Health Officer to the Health Minister.
This bill is a significant improvement on the current legislation. It incorporates many of the key human rights and democracy safeguards that we've been calling for.
Last night, Shadow Treasurer David Davis addressed the protesters and the legislation.
And I say, what on earth do they have to hide?
Matthew Guy says that speech hasn't incited violence against MPs.
And he's right to do that, because it is the most dangerous piece of legislation we've seen to come before the Victorian Parliament, and people must know about it.
The opposition is also demanding Victoria Police reopen its investigation into the red shirt scandal after bombshell evidence from Adam Somurek.
The Andrews government spent nearly $1 million trying to stop the Ombudsman's investigation.
Well, it's been investigated more often than the Kennedy assassination.
Chanel Vella, 7 News.